leadership. One word that has been touted as an important quality ever since we were kids. I remember you were always told, be the class monitor. Be the head girl. Once you join the company, be the team lead. Be a CEO. And then somewhere deep down over the period of time, I heard this word leadership over and over again to a point where I thought that it was an over-preached quality. I mean, really, what did leadership mean to those who have been toiling in the fields for 8 hours in the past and are now toiling 8 hours in front of a screen? What did it mean for a common man? What if one does not want to lead anyone? A very good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests in the room. This cynic in me wondered the futility of this particular quality while I was writing this speech. And it made me think of times that the world has had so many leaders. Some leaders have brought prosperity. Some leaders have brought genocide. Some leaders have brought liberation. And some leaders have ruined an entire country. What was common amongst everyone was power. Being a great leader meant that you had a great deal of power. And ladies and gentlemen, that's where I was wrong. Because when I started looking back at my life, I realized that one does not have to be extremely powerful to be a leader. And suddenly my mind went back into a flashback. I thought of the time when I was in fourth grade. It was a summer camp and we were divided in groups of 10. I was in fourth grade and there were kids up to eighth grade in my group. And we had a very simple task. We were supposed to make a ship from newspapers. We were given some sticks and of course the glue and scissors. While I sat there in my small group, I was hoping that someone would take charge. I could see the kids who were in 7th standard talking amongst themselves. I was like, okay, maybe I'll give it 5 more minutes. I'm sure we're going to do something, right? We have to produce a boat at the end of 10 minutes. Yet, nothing. And I look around and I see other groups have already started pasting their ship together. And suddenly I wonder, what are we going to do? And I look at my friend, who's also in fourth grade. And suddenly, as if it was an epiphany, both of us look at the group and we say, why don't we make a ship which looks like the Titanic? And that was when we took charge. And also it was a very scary thing to do because you know there's someone else in the group who's older to you, who's naturally supposed to take charge, but they did not. And we stepped in and to our surprise, everyone in the group suddenly looked up from their own tiny groups and decided, yeah, that's a great idea. And at the end of 10 minutes, we had a boat to show for it. And at that tender age, I realized that was my very first lesson in leadership. All it takes is an intention and an action. So when there's a problem statement, we always turn to someone else. But what if we turn to ourselves and just display our vision to the world? And you never know. You will always have people who will follow that up. For me, it was the age. But for anyone else, it could be seniority. Flashback number two. I was in 11th grade. Now, I had always been a good student, which meant that everyone hated me, but teachers did like me. A fair deal. So it was not a big surprise for me when I was elected as the Agni House captain. So Agni House was the red house. All schools have 4 houses traditionally. My school had a leaderboard. So from the beginning of an academic year to the end of the academic year, whoever was in whichever house, they would amass points. So it could be any competition that you took part in, or it could be you represented school outside. But one of the biggest contributing factors was the sports day. Now, while I was a book nerd, I knew nothing about sports. I was the girl who could be found sitting in the library during the PT period. Yes, I was that annoying girl. And while the sports day came into my plate, I decided, yeah, I can do this. You know, I can think about this logically. Although I don't know ABC, I can still plan out a strategy in a way that we could win the sports day and then my house would be on top of the charts. And I did this for about 2 weeks and I realized that I was a complete failure at it. I didn't know one thing about sports. And that was my second lesson in leadership, that often when you are in a position of power, you're not expected to know everything, and that is completely okay. Now, once I came to that acceptance, I decided to go up to two, three people in my class, one girl who was actually really good at track events and another guy who was amazing at volleyball. So I went up to them and I told them that, hey, listen, I really need your help, you know, we need to win this thing and I'm not sure how to go about it. You know a lot about sports, can you help me? And whenever you knock on the door of someone, odds are they will say yes, but for that it's important to ask. So that was my third rule, that it's important to collaborate, it's important to ask. With this, my entire spiral of cynicism came to this point, that in your life, if you look back at all the events, be it anything small, you will realize that you all have displayed leadership somewhere. Now, these two incidents in my life will never go on any resume, right? But I know that they were those direction boards in the journey of my life that pointed me to the right direction of the inner qualities that a leader in me would like to imbibe. Now think back, was there a time when you stopped a bully from doing anything to your friend or to your sibling? Was there a time when you offered your seat in the bus to someone older than you? Was there a time when you stood up for yourself and you stopped yourself from taking up that bad habit? If you did, then you have a leader in you. Over to the TM audience.